Bala Mbarugahara was the first to make his way to Parliament among the six newly appointed ministers that faced the Parliamentary Appoints Committee for vetting today. He couldn't hide his excitement for being entrusted by the President to serve as a Minister of State for Youth and Children Affairs and had his aspiration on the fingertips.
Such an honor, and I'm grateful. Everyone is grateful. The country is on fire into my appointment. I want to thank you, and I pledge loyalty to you. I pledge to work for you. I pledge to work for Uganda. I pledge to promote and also solve the biggest problem, which is the youth population.
One by one, the six had checked in before 10 a.m. when they assembled in the speaker's boardroom for scrutiny. Upon vetting, Mbarugahara committed to exploit all possible avenues to secure release of youth who were jailed on political reasons. He revealed that a section of NUP youth have petitioned him on the triggered.
NUP youth, so that those youth can be incorporated in society, be rehabilitated, be skilled, be funded, so that they put energy on development of a country, other than burning streets and burning buildings.
Mbarugahara also vowed to combat teenage pregnancy through mass sensitization and enduring perpetrators abroad to book.
People, about 9 million youth are women. Out of the 90 million, 51% have either been married, forcefully married, or they have conceived, or they have aborted. But the danger for that, or the cause for that, is lack of reproductive health. So we'll focus on reproductive health of young people. Why would a young child of 12, 13, 14 conceive? What a rush for?
Lillian Abba, appointed in the Ministry of Disaster Preparedness, says it will not be business as usual, as she's not ready to meddle in the fights that have engulfed the office of the Prime Minister, while Florence Wamala Nambozo is focused on redeeming the image of the Ministry of Karamoja.
One person who does not breathe conflict. If there is disagreement on principle, it will be handled. But one thing I can guarantee you is that I am not going into that ministry for any petty fight. I'm going there to perform my duties and to deliver services as assigned by my boss.
The things that gives me confidence is I'm not going into a vacuum. There are people who have been there before.
Other appointed ministers outlined wish lists and priorities for their sectoral ministries.
Initiative of the young people, we reflect the energies that the youth have to contribute to the development of this country. So I pledge hard work and integrity to see how best we can maximize the low-hanging fruits of the sector for the development of Uganda.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.